So with the help of Hashem, we are in the Smicha program in Halachot Nida in Siman Kuf Pei Tet, paragraph Yudaled, doing Lel Chazara here. הייתה רגילה לראות יום 20 ויש לה בזה וסקבוע. So she is accustomed to see in the 20th of the month or every 20 day, more precisely. And she have a casual status quo with it. שינתה ליום 30. All of a sudden, one month came after 30 days. זה וזה אסורים. So for the next month, she have to be careful in both. שהגיע יום כף לראיית 30, so after 20 days from that 30th, אסורה משום וסת הראשון, so that will be prohibited because of the first status quo she had. אם לא תראה בו, if she didn't see in the after 20 days, חושד ליום למד, so she have to worry also after 30 days from the last period. שינתה פעמיים ליום למד, זה וזה אסורים. After two times, second time of 30, still, also the 20 and also the 30 are prohibited. Shinta gimel b'yom liyom lamed, but after three times of 30 days gap, mutar yom kav v'nesar yom lamed. So the status quo of the 20 days is removed, and then she doesn't have to worry about it anymore. And the 30th day becomes to be the new status quo, so now she will have to worry about this one. אם לאחר שינתה פעם או פעמיים ליום למד, ראתה לסוף כף. חזר וסת של כף למקומו ואותר 30. After once or twice she saw the 30 days, so it means she didn't remove the status quo of the 20, and she did not reset herself to the status quo of 30. So therefore, the moment she sees in 20 again, so the 20 comes back and the 30 is removed because it was not set in three times. Yeah?
So in order for it to go to make a break, does it have to be three times?
Yes. Three times, that's what makes a difference. That's the name of the game.
What's the purpose of going into all these specific cases when this is a rule they established in the very beginning? I say if it's a rule of three, if you have three in a row, and good. If you have three in a row, it takes away the status quo. It's the same concept, but they're repeating it over and over and over again.
Well, isn't it fun?
No, but what's the purpose?
Okay, so I understand your question, fine. But there is nuances. There is all kinds of like small possibilities and nuances of to be sensitive about.
Oh.
Yeah.
To each specific case you're saying.
Yeah. Also, you have to remember that a big portion of the books of Halacha is what we call shoot. Shoot is question and answers. Yeah, shelot v'tshuvot.
This is part of it.
So many of the foundations of Halacha is because there was cases like that, and they asked the rabbi, and he wrote what he told them. He wrote in his book. And then, so many of those things that we're reading about, they're coming from those books of questions and answers of those, like, old generation rabbis, yeah?
Did they have them separated into just the halachot and then just the pashut that you're talking about in two different areas, or they all, this is Shulchan Aruch, they're together? But their sources
in Shulchan Aruch, it goes according to the order of the simanim of the two. But he's summarizing within the Shulchan Aruch also all kinds of questions and answers that he was learning in his time 500 years ago, whatever.
Right.
So the world of Halacha is big and wide.
Yeah.
And because there's all kinds of different cases, and many of the cases are repetitive, right, in different variations. So it's good to know like all those different cases and to see what was the way that those rabbis were relating to those, you know, like cases that came to them.
Right.
Specifically, if you want to be a rabbi and you need to learn how to give answers in halacha,
right.
So that's one of the basic requirements, you know, that you have a case and you have to go over the case and see what halachot it falls into, and how to give it over to people, you know. Many times I said that a rabbi is like a doctor. And so today, doctors, they're not so much humans. They're more like a like computer program. You tell them like what you have, and they type it in the computer, and it gives them the medicine that what you need to take, and they tell you that. We don't really need a doctor for that, right? But the like the old-fashioned doctors, so it was not like that. They speak with the person and see what is like emotional state and what is the background. It's not just like you have this, you have to take that, right? And in Halacha, it's like the old-fashioned doctors. It's not like you have like those ingredients within your question, so it must be that the answer will be the following. You can take the same case with the same ingredients and put it in a little bit different order, and you get a different result. And it's like, and the answer is different according to the person, according to the situation, according to the time, according to the need. Right? We're human beings. We're sensitive to like the situation and whatever is needed. Right? So you see that sometimes the halacha is more strict, sometimes it's more loose. And Rabbi, you have to choose when to be more strict, when to be more loose, according to the situation, whatever is the need of the people, right? So you have to know all those like variations of like the same case, but a little bit different here, a little bit different there. What do you do in this case? What do you do in that case? And when you get like the all of that like in the back of your mind, so then when you have a question, so you can analyze the question, the situation, to be able to give the answer that will be the right answer for this specific case, for this specific person in this time, in this period of his life, whatever it is. And that's what is required for a rabbi to do. Okay. So, Bayeritev, Kaf Vav, Kavua. The Imloken, Kivan de Shinta, Beyom Kaf, Nekar Hashash Yom Kaf. Okay, the moment that she didn't see after 20 days, so she changed her period. It will not be after 20 days. Okay? Excuse me. If she didn't have a status quo for 20, yeah? Was just one time that she saw after 20 days. So if she doesn't have a status quo, so the next time that she doesn't see in 20, so that removes the need to be worried about the 20 days gap. Yeah? Again, when she have a status quo that there was 3 times to set it up, so now you need 3 times in a row to remove it. But if she didn't have a status quo, it was just like one time that she saw in the 20 or 2 times that she saw in the 20. So then you don't need 3 times in a row to remove it because it was not a status quo. So one time she didn't see in the 20, she saw in 30 days. That's it. So now she doesn't have to worry about the 20 anymore. Right?
At this point, the rules of the status quo, they don't apply because you never have one.
Right. כף זין, 30. אבל אין מונים כף משעה שהייתה ראויה לראות ליום כף, כיוון שלא ראתה באותו יום המתינה עד יום לעמיד. Right? So you would think maybe she need to count 20 days, not only from the practical day that the period came, also from the day that she was worried that it should come, meaning she was expecting to see after 20 days, and she didn't so. She saw after 30 days. So now she's counting 20 days from that period that she got after 30 days. And she doesn't have to count 20 days from the period that didn't come after 20 days. Yes? Okay.
But there was a break in process, right?
I don't know what you mean when you say break. There was, she had a set period, status quo, every 20 days.
Yeah.
The 20 days came, she didn't see.
Yeah.
After 10 days, in the 30th day, then she saw.
Oh.
Yeah? So now watch what she do. So she's counting 20 days from that period that she got, that was after 30 days from the previous one. And then she expecting to see after 20 days from that last period. And there was a Hava Amina, maybe you would think to say that she needs also to count 20 days from that period that she didn't see, that was supposed to be after 20 days. The answer is no, because she didn't see, so she doesn't have to count from that.
Right, there was a concept that we learned, if I remember, that we count from when you see.
Exactly.
Kafret.
Lemkomo. כתב הראש אף על פי שג' פעמים לא ראתה ביום כף. So the Rosh says, even though she didn't see three times in the 20th. Okay? And it's not clear what the Rosh wants to say here. Doesn't really make sense. So we have those brackets that are trying to explain it. And he says, לא נעקר יום כף כיוון שלא ראתה יום למד. שאם אישה מדלגת וסת אחד או פעמיים או שלוש, אינה רואה בינתיים לזמן אחר. חוזרת לראות לווסת, לא נעקר הווסת. So there's a question of what exactly the case we're talking about. Yeah? The case is not clear. She saw how many times she didn't see in the 20th. So it seems that it seems to be that the Rosh is talking about a different case that the way that we understood, and he's talking about that there was three times that she didn't see in the 20th. Yeah, no, it's not what we understood in the case. And he says even so, the 20th was not removed. Okay, so the question is why? If she didn't see three times in a row in the 20th,
right,
it should be the status quo of the 20 will be removed.
Right.
So it seems that the Rosh is saying that no, she didn't see three times in a row in the 20th, and still it is not removed.
Right.
Why? So his reasoning, כיוון שלא ראתה יום למד, because she didn't see each one of those times in the 30th day. So it seems to say that the way that the Rosh understands this halacha is that after she got the status quo, she don't remove it with to no status quo. She needs to remove it to a different status quo. Right? We saw this possibility before. That's the opinion of the Rosh. We don't hold like this. But that's the opinion of the Rosh, seems to see.
We don't hold like this.
We don't. שאם אישה מדלקת וסת אחד או פעמיים ושלוש, so he says even three times, and now I've been a time lezman acher, but she didn't move to a different status quo. Chozer lirot bezman avezet, and then she goes back to that previous status quo she had. Lo nekar avezet, so that last status quo was not removed. Okay. So that's the opinion of the Rosh. Magid Mishne katav da tur sover lav davka shelo rata shlosh ba shloshim shlishit ela shadayin lo yegia. Afilo ach kol shechazra verata lekaf chazra lekviut harishon. Okay, the tour is saying a little bit different, that when she didn't see in the 30th, in the third time, meaning she didn't get to the 30th day because she saw after 20 days, yeah? Two times she saw after 30 days, and then third time she saw after 20 days. So maybe we have to wait. Maybe she will see more or again after 30 days from the last period, and then she doesn't get that status quo back of the 20.
So the original, in this case, the original status quo was the 20 days.
Right. And so he says, no, you don't have to wait to the 30 days. The moment that she saw after 20, so she went back to the status quo, and she doesn't have to worry about the 30 anymore, because it was not set.
Because she goes back to the 20.
Yeah.
Okay. I see.
Okay. אף על פי שלא נעקר עדיין, על ידי שלא ראתה בו. So, it was not removed because she didn't have three times in a row that she didn't see it in the 20th. אפילו אחרי זה שראתה בכף, שהוא יום קביעות הראשון. So the fact that she saw after 20 days, which is the first day of the status quo, מחשיב לה להכירה של בית ראיות. So that counts as removing the possibility of status quo of seeing two times in the 30 days. Because she didn't have the third one, so like those two times doesn't count for nothing. ודין זה צריך עיון דלא משמע כן בשס. עד כאן דבריו, דברי השח. אוקיי. So the Shach is saying that it's very strange the way they say it. It doesn't really make sense. And okay, that's what he says. אתה אז כתב לתרס, יש חילוק בין ימי החודש דמיזה מיירי בשס. So the Taz says that it's different when you're talking about the Veset Aflaga, the gap, possibility for the period, gap of days, or the days of the month. That if it was talking about the days of the month, מזה מירי בשס, אבל המחבר מירי בהפלגת ימים מיום למד. So he's talking about like the difference of days from the 30 days to 20 days. כאן כתב, לאחר ששינתה פעם או פעמיים, okay, so that's why he says, like after once or twice, okay. So, okay, so there's a discussion again about like what exactly is the case. There's, between those different opinions that we saw here, we have like, the opinions of what exactly happened there. And obviously when you're changing the case, so also the what will be the halakha then will be different. Okay. So I want to go to the next paragraph, but I think we have to hold it here, unfortunately, a little bit short today. But we did got to do something, Baruch Hashem for that, and Bezrat Hashem to be continued tomorrow with the help of Hashem.